It would seem there are some things for which you're never too old. In the case of our next guest, it was bringing out his first solo album at the age of 53 and then being told off by his mum for swearing on it.
Henry Priestman, who found fame and fortune with the band The Christians in the 80s and 90s, has been described as the grumpy old man of music. So I've got something in common with him. Now, after 30 years of trying, he's finally finding success as a solo artist. Henry is here. First, here's his current single, Don't You Love Me No More.
There I was, in all my naivety, thinking you cared, I really believed in me, but all I got was a thing called redundancy. You gave me a clock, now it stopped. Too many chiefs and not enough Indians, I was only ever one of the minions. I sat and I listened to all your opinions, I gave all I got till I dropped. Don't you love me no more? Don't you want me no more? One little word and the line's getting blurred on what's wrong and what's right. Don't you need me no more? Won't you feed me no more? Tell me what you suggest that I do with the rest of my life.
Fabulous, fabulous single. With us now is Henry Priestman. Very good morning.
Good morning
to you. We were just talking then. You were saying, gosh, it's quite strange being back. The last time you were back in studios and talking music was when?
Probably 1993. I think we did a Top of the Pops in 93, I think. Mm. So this is all very strange.
Just goes to show it's never too late to rock and roll.
Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah. So what kick-started the comeback? I was reading 2007, you were persuaded to start singing again by the songwriter Tom Gilbert.
Tom Gilbert, yeah, Tom, he bullied me. We wrote a song called Old, which has the line in, I'm the same age that my father was when I first thought he was old. And that's where we started it, and we couldn't find anybody else to sing it apart from me. So I sang the demo, not thinking anything would come of it. And then we were quite pleased with what we'd done, so we just carried on doing it, but didn't think anything would happen. And, you know, I thought I might sell it on my MySpace or... And it's gone mad, and yeah. I'm here.
And yeah. I think you have the distinction, correct me if I'm wrong, of being the oldest person to be offered a new contract, recording contract.
As a solo, somebody came up with this.
As a solo artist?
I'm the oldest person to be offered their first solo deal, yes.
Fantastic.
How does that make you feel?
Very old. I'm just taking it with a total pinch of salt, just enjoying it.
Do you think it's there's bound to be a prejudice against older artists in the popular music industry.
Well, there is in some ways, but what I'm doing is I'm sort of outside. It's like I'm not really in the mainstream. I'm not sure. But I'm just running with it, enjoying it.
And how different is it this time round then for you in terms
more
of
fun.
You say, more fun?
It's more fun because I know the pitfalls and I know what not to do. And I'm not taking it seriously.
Yeah.
I'm singing about serious issues.
Yes, so what you are taking seriously, and let's talk about then the single that we've just heard, is the state of play at the moment, particularly in terms of the financial climate.
Yeah, and this was written in 2007, so it was a friend of mine who got made redundant, and I was angry, and it all came out, literally, probably took about 2 hours to write the song. And as you say, sadly, you know, now it's got so much more relevance. And quite a few of the other songs, there's a song called... it's called A Heart, and that's when you're looking at these bankers, you know, let me introduce you to a new idea, it's called A Heart. You know, you seem to think some of them, they have resonance, so much more resonance than even 1.5 years ago.
Mm.
Mm. It's a long way from The Christians.
It's different. Any Christians fans will probably be going, well for a start, I can't. And Gary had a fantastic voice, still has a fantastic voice. I've not got a great voice, but I do my best.
Let's take you back in time.
Okay, go on then.
Your days
go
on Top of the Pops.
Same hat.
Same cap.
Same cap.
Obviously,
yes.
You haven't got big headed over
no,
the years.
No, no, no. Less hair. Same cap.
You wrote that song as well. So you're still campaigning to a degree, wasn't it? Harvest
yes.
for the World.
It's funny because somebody said, well, am I a protest singer? And it's like, not really. But I suppose I always haven't shied away from, you know, issues if they affect me or affect yeah. people I know.
You brought in an instrument.
Yeah, I brought a ukulele.
Right.
Apparently ukulele sales are going through the roof. Yeah. I don't know why. Shall I do you a little song?
Yes, please, yeah.
Okay, this one's called... This is from the album. This is for my wife. We've managed to stay together for 30 years, and this is called Grey's New Blonde. When I first met you, petrol was cheap, so was the company that I chose to keep. One more bite of the cherry, one more sip from the vine. You're extraordinary, you get better with time. So don't cry to the mirror as the pages get turned. Grey's a new blonde, as far as I'm concerned.
Lovely. No, I'm an old softy anyway, but that just actually brings tears to my eyes. What? It must be lovely for your wife to sit and listen to all the girls, and I can hear them make, oh, that's so lovely.
Women do seem to like that. So.
I know, yeah.
Yeah, no, it's... And I love playing. I've never played it on this before until last night, and I suddenly thought, well, it seems I'm going to play it on this now.
What's really refreshing, and I suppose this is older ears talking now, is that listening to your album, you can hear every line and every word first time round without having to try to decipher it through the other stuff that's there. And it's important because the message is...
Yeah, I mean, I think I've always liked, with the Christians, we always had the vocals probably louder than most people because the voices were important then. And this the voice isn't necessarily important now, but the lyric is. So, I just want... they're all stories, and it's about stories about my life. It's funny because for the last... since I left the Christians, you know, I've been trying to write songs to get on the radio, and it hasn't really happened. But then you write about your own life, and suddenly it seems
to
be happening. Yeah,
all over the radio
it's
at
strange,
the moment,
yes.
As I keep hearing. Yeah. So what next, and what?
Well, I've just finished a tour, which was great because I didn't know whether I could do that. I didn't know whether I could do the patter and you know, remember the lines. I mean, but it doesn't matter. I make mistakes, and they seem to like me more.
Yeah.
I made a mistake in that song, actually. I don't know if you've
spoken. Yeah. And you got to play in the O2 as well, the arena.
Yes, with 10cc. That was brilliant. That was my first ever gig, and that was a bit nerve-wracking. So I just keep ticking. So now I can say, right, I've done Breakfast TV, tick that one off. Didn't make too much of a fool
just
of myself.
A step along the way.
No, I'm just...
The Grammys obviously beckon.
Maybe.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Henry, thanks very much for
coming. Yeah,
real
pleasure to meet you.
Good luck with the album. Thank you very much.
Lovely.